Hello everyone and welcome to a tutorial on RPG developer Bakin. Today I'm going to show you how this bump battle system works. This is somewhat based off the, I don't know how to say it, YS system. But I've kind of improved it to my own needs. Ooh, that is really loud. One second. Okay. So whenever you bump into them, you attack, and then, okay, that needs to be fixed a little bit, but you attack from behind, you'll do double damage. And since I wasn't close enough, it wasn't able to hit me. And now he's dead. Okay, see, he wasn't close enough to hit me, but I was right there when he hit me, so. All right, you get the basic idea. Let me close that. All right, so it's actually really super simple to make. You're gonna make a couple of common events, or at least a common event. To start, we're gonna go ahead and grab the player's coordinates at all times. So you'll make it just like this, or it's already made just like this. And the beauty of this whole system is actually run through the actual event. This is just a setup event, setting up the display, the heroes, HP, and then I don't use the cast information, only the HP I'll use because of for the layout editor. You can use whatever you'd like here. But I just set the attack to 5 and the accuracy to 85. I wouldn't set it any higher than about 90, and no lower than like 65, and you'll see in a minute. All right, so go into the database. I have my little elf enemy here. Starting from the bottom, it is very important you keep this priority system, because starting from the bottom up, it is a priority system. So initialize is always going to be on the bottom. You need to make sure that this flag switch is off, and you'll have these local variables here, which are already all set up here. Here I'm setting the random value of 35 to 50. I like doing this with my enemies because it gives every single enemy variety. And they're not all having the exact same HP attack and all that. And this system only uses HP and attack, so this doesn't factor in any kind of defense or anything. Somewhat is your defense is kind of your accuracy. I set the accuracy for them to 75 because I feel that's a good number. Then once you are finished setting up your enemy's attributes, you will turn the init switch on, which will go to the next page, dead. So that we need to have the dead as highest priority, so that way, or next highest priority. Why is it not going away? Come on, tooltip. Okay, whatever. Tooltip's gonna stay. This is a bug. You need to make sure that this is your next priority because we want to be able to kill them instantly. I don't have anything set up here right now. I do have the collision settings and everything. You want to turn all that off so that way you're not doing more damage to it and it's not trying to damage you. All this, just make sure it's idle. Doesn't matter about the speed and everything. And make your motion to your KO animation. Here you can put like your drops, you can put like XP gains and everything, you can delete the enemy. I didn't do any of that because I just didn't really feel the need to. Alright, so the attack timer, this is actually really cool. So what we're doing here is we are making the delta variable assigned to the elapsed time frame. Which, let's see if it even has a tooltip. No, it doesn't, of course not. So what that does is pretty much it goes by the speed of your computer. So if you have a really fast computer, the time frame will be a little bit faster, but it'll be the exact same for everyone. So it doesn't matter how fast or how slow it is. The actual weight function does have delta time into it, but I kind of like it, or kind of like doing it this way, because I know for a fact it's going to be proper timing. So this will be explained in the next event sheet. Attack time, this is whenever we attack, we're going to turn this switch on, starting this timer. We're going to wait the variable time frame of the delta, so that way it'll tick properly. We're going to add one to this local variable timer, and then once that reaches 50, we're going to put it turn it to zero, and we're going to turn that switch off, meaning we can the enemy can attack again. Again, the event sheets are always going to be the same from here on out, pretty much. You're always going to have dead off and initialize off or on. There it goes. Oh, there it went away. All right. So now here's the meat and potatoes of the whole system. Same sheet conditions and everything. So this part right here is whenever the player is in front of an enemy. I put little notes here saying it's player in front of the enemy, then attack player, no collision needed. I didn't turn the collision on because I kind of, you want to make it kind of quick to where the enemy is going to be, if the enemy isn't right in front of the player and the player is right in front of the enemy, it's going to be able to attack. This condition right here is a state, is whenever you hit for the first time, because it won't hit you until you start hitting it. You can change that, of course, to whatever you'd like. We put to when the attack time is off, meaning we have not attacked yet, and put it here to check to see if what attack timer is on. You assign a random number between 1 and 100 to your hit chance, and then you're going to compare that to your accuracy. So if it is less than your accuracy, you will be able to attack, or the enemy will be able to attack. So we wait, you do your attack motion here. I would always turn the attack switch on right here about, so that way, ooh, I need to turn that off because that's going to make it keep attacking. Not right there, my bad. You're going to want to put it down here. All right, so down here. All right. Oh, no, I'm sorry. I was right. Come on, go back. All right, that was just a little glitch in my ear. So whenever you're attacking, you're going to want to turn this attacking switch on, because there'll be another part coming up soon where we're going to stop the event altogether, and that's going to wait about a little bit before the step of its movement, and then it's going to check to see if our total distance is less than or equal to 1 from the player. So if it is, we'll be able to attack. You might want to make this directional, to where if the event is facing a certain direction and the player, you would want to do this. This is just super simple right now. You're going to change the player's damage. You're going to disable their operation. You're going to do your effects here, and then you're going to take the value off here. You don't have to have any HP zero checks, because it's already automatically being done in the system. And then you're going to want to make sure you change. Actually, here, let me put that down here. Change the motions back to normal, and then enable player operation again. You want to have, you don't want the player to move when you're attacking, so that way it'll kind of register it properly. And then now, if conditions are not met, meaning our accuracy is greater than the hit chance, we're going to have our miss conditions down here. So you want to stop the player yet again. The enemy is going to swing. We're going to wait, and it's going to display an effect on the player. And then we need to make it so. And then enable the player, and then the attack timer on, because it did attack. All right, from here on out, the left and the right are the exact same. Now we are handling the event being attacked. So we want to make sure that when we bump into the event, it is going to check if we are about a fourth of a grid away from the event. then we are going to do the exact same thing, but we're just swapping the variables around. We're going to do the hit chance. It's still going to be the same, but the accuracy is going to be based upon the player about how well they can hit. Still same thing. We're going to disable our operation. We're going to face it towards, this event, and it'll only face towards the event you're attacking. It does get a little finicky whenever you start getting on top of enemies start getting on top of each other. It's going to be swapping back and forth. There's probably a way to fix this, but I'll update it eventually. You're going to wait, and then you're change the motion to the event to damage. So this is showing that the event enemy is getting damaged. You're going to assign the state to 1 because we are attacking it. This is going to be for the whole time. We're going to wait a little bit. We're going to have our effects here, and then we're going to subtract the player's attack from the event's enemy or the enemy's HP. We need to have if HP is equal or less than 0 check here, and we're going to turn their switch on if they are dead. Return their motion here. Same thing for the miss. It's doing the exact same thing. Right is the exact same thing we just did with the left. Now the back, the only thing that I did different is you double the attack. So that way there's kind of an advantage from attacking from behind. And the exact same thing here. So now this is all finished. We're going to go to after hit moving. It's a little bit more complex. We need to have a collide range. A custom collide range, because it needs to be able to hit or properly collide with the player. So we're going to go here. You're going to make it about the exact same size as the event, maybe in a little bit taller. You can have it as wide as you'd like. I keep it about the same width of the sprite or the 3D model. This is where we're not, you don't want to have any movement here because we're going to be doing our own here. Make sure it's idle. Doesn't really matter. All this movement speed, frequency, yada. Same thing. We need to make sure that our state is set to 1. This is our moving and attacking to the player state. Back to that attacking switch we have right here. Is going to be set to off here, because once we set it to on, we're going to be going to the stop. But what this is doing is checking if the total distance is greater than 1, then we can move towards the player and make sure we face towards the player. Stop, the exact same page pretty much. We're just going to face towards the player and turn the switch on. This isn't gonna have any movement whatsoever, so this is going to be the page where it's going to stop, face the player, and attack. Coordinates, if you've seen my tutorial before on how to do a distance check, this is doing a distance check. This is always running. We are assigning x local variable to this local variable x. Same for the z. And then we're going to assign the local x to distance x. Same for the distance z. Then we're going to subtract the player's x from the distance x, and then subtract the player's z from the distance z. And then we're going to add the two together. And then we're going to assign that to the total distance, and that will give our value of how far away the player is from that event. Very simple with this too. This is the wander state. This is before they get attacked. You can just have it random, or you can even make it to where you have your own motions here. It doesn't really matter. Just make sure you have your equal state to 0. Apply. All right. And the beauty about this is you can place as many as you like. So I'll place a couple more just for fun. And save. Now I'm going to go ahead and turn on collision so you can kind of see what's going on. So you can see that my collision box is right here, and I'm colliding with this enemy. So he attacked, but he missed. So I got him. He's still attacking, or he's still walking around. So I hit him, so he's gonna chase me now. All right, and I'm in front of him. Okay, since I'm in front of him, he attacked me, but see, I was able to move out of the way quick enough, because if you're quick enough, you can miss the attack altogether, even with a miss. Without a miss. So he's attacked. See, I was in front, so he hit me. Alright. Oh. Well, to fix that. Alright. Hide that. Close. Alright, that was a little bit of bug. I didn't fix that easily. I just need to go to the enemies, and then whenever you are done, the enemy dies. We will just make it so the player can move again. Enable. Okay, that should fix it. Alright, so that's about it. I'm going to go ahead and zip this up, and I will put it in the Discord. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact me. And thank you for watching, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye-bye.